Hi everyone, it's Claire here today with the reveal of my June kit for the Wild Hair Kit Club. This month I'm working with one of our deluxe kits and I am currently in a state of shock. I'd forgotten just how much was included in the deluxe kits because I've been working with our petite size kits for the last few months. So I have so much product here in front of me and I'm just going to crack on and show you what's included in my kit this month. I've got some fabulous papers and some amazing embellishments. So the only thing that I really want to tell you before I start showing you all the goodies is that this month when I did my style profile, I chose to send my own mood board to the curators instead of choosing one of the mood boards that is on our style profile. So if you've not seen it yet, go and have a look so that you know what I'm talking about. But typically you're able to choose between four different mood boards to help guide the curators with the style of your kit. And then you're able to fill out some free text options that show the curators what kind of projects you're working on and so that they can bear in mind what products you love using and what products you don't like using. I wanted a slightly different feel for my kit than the mood boards we have currently and asked if I could just email one over as the basis of my kit this month, and it's worked perfectly. So do feel like this is an option for you. The customer service at the Wild Hair Kit is phenomenal and the curators there will do everything that they can to make your kit perfect just for you. So I'm going to show you at some point the mood board that I sent over. It's full of natural elements like marble, wood, some kind of granites, I think. There's a lot of texture in there that's kind of brought through into my kit. I asked for some natural elements like leaves, small florals, and also you'll see that there's a fantastic match between my style profile and these embellishments here. So I'm really, really thrilled with what I've got. So let's make a start on the papers. This is from Highly Swapped Hawthorne Collection. This is the 9th and 9th paper. And you've got the cut aparts on this side, which they're kind of meh for me. I like the ledger and the diagonal stripe and the mountains. The mountains will always call. But this is the side that really has drawn me in and fits really well with the mood board that I sent. It's full of these kind of natural textures here. Then I've got some Highly Swapped, some more Highly Swapped. This is from the Pineapple Collection, Pineapple Crush Collection. This is the Breezy paper, and on this side it's got the kind of like a watercolour effect, and then there's this classic stripe on the back. So that's really versatile, and I love the colours. Then I've got two of our cut apart sheets. You can request these in your style profile, but if you're buying a deluxe kit then they're included as well. So I've got this one here with some stars, and I will definitely use the little negative from it. Or is this the positive? I'm not sure. But this is the cut apart sheet. Let's see if I can just show you that there with these stars. And I don't normally use these because I normally work in a format that's smaller than 12 by 12. So this is going to be a challenge for me, and I do like a challenge, so that's fantastic. And then, excuse me, I've got one here with these butterflies as well. I think Alison has included two for me this month because I haven't had any of the deluxe kits for a little while. So she's helping me catch up. Then this paper is fantastic, but I think I like this side better. So this is from Crepe Paper. It's from the Wild Heart Collection. And obviously got the palm leaves on this side, but it's got this kind of natural, probably Hessian or basket weave or something side here, which is fantastic. and works really well with the style profile that I sent over. This is so cute. I love these little boats. Like, it's so nice. And I love this teal side as well, but I suspect that the other side is what's been included for me. This is Paige Evans Pick Me Up, paper 22. Oh yeah, look at that. So I get really excited. Basically, you know, some people get really excited the more colour there is. I think I get more excited the less colour there is. I really like these neutrals and these very soft, subtle patterns. That's fantastic, so that's really pretty. I've got this lovely paper from, I think this is Jen Hadfield. So this is Jen Hadfield's Patio Party. This is the Just For You Cut Apart. Again, on this side, there's lots of natural elements like the leaves, the ferns, obviously all the really cute florals. And then on this side, there's this nice neutral that would be perfect for a background. This kind of reminds me of school exercise books. Maybe I'll do a layout about something like that. And then I've got a sheet of wood grain from Heidi Swap's Hawthorne collection. This is the Hawthorne paper. Now I don't really like this side, but I do really like this side. This is fantastic. So here's my kind of neutral kit. You'll be able to see how well it matches the mood board that I sent. It's so good, and was actually, it's weird, it wasn't what I was expecting, but now that I've got it in front of me, I can't think of anything better. So yeah, it's really fantastic. And then I've got lots more paper in the form of Project Life cards. So I'm always catching up on Project Life. Like, always catching up, I'm never up to date. So Alison's included a few of these for me, in some neutral colours and some kind of soft, subtle patterns. Look how cute this is. I really like these. So I've got lots of wood grain. And this will either help me with my Project Life catch up. Or some of these might be suitable for Week in the Life, which I did last month. Well, I say I did last month. I took all the photographs and I did some of the journaling, but I never finished Week in the Life during Week in the Life. So, of course, I have that to catch up on as well. And then I have some 3x4s, again, with like the neutral patterns that work really well with my 12x12s. And these kind of natural elements like little birds and some green. Or I don't know what it is at the moment, I'm always craving green. Maybe I should eat more vegetables. Here we go, look at this. Look how perfect this is. Oh yes. I love that. Right, let's get on to the embellishments, because I have a stack of them here. I'm going to start with these. These are the little butterflies from the Cut Apart. So I'll probably be able to use these separately as little embellishments. I think they're really cute. So maybe they'll come up on a page. I've got some fantastic washi. These are from Wild at Heart, I think. Look at these. Oh gosh, it's so beautiful. It's kind of like a coppery rose gold colour. And it's so nice. And then I've got this green one. Look how, it's so nice. It's kind of got this fern pattern on it. That's going to be on everything this summer. Oh yeah. Because I have lots of gardening pages to do. I've got some twine in this kind of natural, I don't know what this is. Is this Hessian? Is it jute? I don't know. I can't remember. But that's really cute. And I like that it's got a little bit of fun texture. Then I've got these, which I love. They're fantastic. In terms of my usual style of embellishments. These are huge. I don't normally include big embellishments on any of my layouts or projects. And although I do tend to embellish a lot more in mini books, they're quite big even for that, but these are incredible. I really liked them when I saw them come out last year. And as you'll see from my mood board photo, there's a reason that these have been included. This one, I think. It looks just like it. It's really amazing, and the colours work so well. And I've got a couple of ideas of how I'm going to use these that might be a little bit different to usual, my usual thing. I've got some here and there embellishments. I told our curators that I really liked these, so these have been included, and I think I'm going to get some use out of these this month, because I will be going on holiday. I'm so excited. So that's great. I've got, I do not have a case of the Blahs, but I have Pink Fresh, a case of the Blahs, enamel dots. I really like these. Again, look how well they work with all of the things that I've got here. Some here and there die cut pieces. This is so thick. There's just so many of them in here that I'm not even going to run through because I think it would make the video so long. But you can see what's included there. There's lots and lots of really cute die cuts. I love this world map. There's some leaves in here that work with my theme. Adventures, flying, loads of arrows. It's just fantastic. I really like it. And I'm going to get so much use out of these. And then last but not least, I've got some of these tassel bows from the BU collection by Pinkfresh Studios. Again, I asked for something a little bit more textural this time in my kit, because I tend to use quite flat embellishments. And these are going to be a little bit of a challenge for me, but new and fun. And I can't wait to get these on my page. So that's it. Look at this amazing kit. I'm going to have so much fun this month. Please go and have a look at the videos from the rest of the members of the DT. I'll leave links to their videos in the comment box below so that you can go and visit and see what kind of kits they've asked for this month and how they've been curated just for us. I'll also leave links to the Wild Hair Kit style profile so that you can have a look at how that normally works, and I'll make sure that you see the mood board that I've used as the basis of my kit. Okay, thanks a lot.